Oh, sorry about that. We had a little bit of technical difficulty, but we're back. And I cannot kind of remember where I'm at, but let's just go with it. Okay, so what I'm saying is, I remember when I first started, and you know, I went out, I bought anything that was cheap. Oh yeah, I could do this, I could do that, I could do this. I've still got some of those pieces down, and it's been a year, a little over a year. So be selective in what you're buying. That's the one thing that I learned. And enjoy what you're doing. You know, number one thing is when you're getting ready to do a piece, this is an old piece. I don't know if some of you remember these pieces. I remember them from whenever I was little, and my mom loved the gold. And so she had this whole room that was just all, you know, the golds and the creams. And that maybe that's the reason why I like cream so much. I don't know. But anyway, so these old gold mirrors, this is the triple one, and I really love them. I mean, they're beautiful, but let's just face it, that's not real beautiful. That's outdated. I picked this up, actually my daughter, I saw it when we were in California, and I called my daughter and said, could you go get this for me? And so she did. So we're going to give this thing an overhaul. So I wanted to show you what I'm using. And it's right here. I use Designer in You paint. I'm going to bring that up for me a little bit so you can see it. I love the way this paint goes on, and it just does so well. It dries quickly. It adheres absolutely awesome. I know what I was going to say. The first thing you want to do is clean it. I thought I had them right here. But I got me a scrub brush. I got into all of those crevices in there, cleaned out all of the dust, everything all the way around. Because you know, if something's dusty, it's not going to hold the paint. So take your time and clean your objects really well. And you'll be glad. Because then in a little while, you're not going to have that crusty stuff as you paint. It's not going to get into your paint. It's not going to get into your finish. And it's going to give you a cleaner line. And in something like this, that's what you want. So I got my Designer in You, and it's called Grandma's Pearls. It's one of my favorites as far as the color.
Tracy Dawn says, hi, Carolyn.
Hey, Tracy. How are you? So I'm going to fill in all of these little crevices. And hopefully y'all can see what I'm doing. I am not being picky. I just want to get my first coat, a good coat. And the other thing I wanted to say too, is that I taped this off. And the reason that I taped it off, some people don't. I used to not tape it off. Whenever I was doing a mirror, I would just paint and then I'd take like a scraper or something and then scrape it all and get a real clean look. What I found though on a couple of my mirrors is that as I was scraping with the razor blade, it caused scratches on it and that distressed me. So now what I do is I go through and I tape them. I am going to have some cleanup. I am going to have some, because this is so curly-cuey and ornate and stuff, that I am going to have some cleanup on this. But I'm not going to worry about it, because if I have a few places I have to scrape, that's okay. And I want to make sure that I work my brush in. I've got a smaller brush too that I'll be working with that'll get into all those little crevices. And I just put my paint in a little tub right here. Well, you guys might not be able to see it, but it says Roxy. And my daughter has two horses. Actually, she's the one who's taping this. Say hi, Mariah.
Hi.
And one of her horses' name is Roxy. So she has to put their feed in these little tubs. So I have her save them for me when they get yuck and she can't use them anymore. So she brings them to Mom, and Mom paints out of them. Because if my paint dries in there, I just throw them away. It's great. So we get a lot of bang out of our buck. So if anyone has any questions, Tracy, where do you live? I forget. And if she answers, you can just tell me. Make sure that when you're putting on your paint, that it's good and layered. You don't have to worry about everything, like all those little crannies, because we're going to come back with a black glaze. And this is the finish that I did on that I posted on several of the sites. And so everyone kind of seemed to really like it. So I thought, well, you know what? I'm going to mimic that finish. Use the same products. Now, some people just like to do that and hit the highlights. You know, if you like that look, go for it. You know, it's all about perspective of what you like and what you think will sell. Now, I'm selling this.
Tracy says she lives in South Florida.
South Florida. Where at, Tracy? Well, you might not want to say that. I don't know. We visit there quite a bit, actually, and in our travels. So, who knows? I know when we were in California, a friend of mine that's on several of our painting sites, we always go back and we, you know, post on each other's things and encourage each other. And I want to say that too about
Delray.
We go a lot by Sarasota and Inglewood and that area. Ferkel from there? Well, I know I'm probably Ferkel. Pronouncing her name wrong. Mm. But I think she was from there. Tracy? But anyway, this keeps wanting to drip on me. So you just work it in there. You can kind of see it's a little tedious. I always try to look underneath because you know you're going to forget something. Keep going back to that place because for some reason it's wanting to pull my paint and my paint gets drippy. So we are going to just continue all the way around this mirror. And I probably won't bore you guys with the whole thing unless you just want to stay on here and talk to me. But, I love doing mirrors. I really do. Because you can take a mirror like this you can take a mirror like this that normally people pass over and you can give it such a luxurious look. And now some people aren't going to like this. Now, the other thing too that I wanted to say is as designers, a lot of times, you know, we want to do a lot of different looks. It's what keeps us happy, is being able to do different looks. And that's good, you know, because you always want to keep your fresh edge. But you've also got to think, or at least I do, is what's my audience? Who am I selling to? Who's going to like this? And there's some times where I just do that piece that is going to take that special buyer. And I take it and I enjoy it and I do it. But then there's also times where you've just got to do your pieces that are going to sell easier. And like I was talking to my daughter, I thought about doing color underneath the cream and then, you know, distressing it, and then you could see the color come out. But we have got a couple big festivals coming up at my antique shop that I'm part of. And I thought, you know, maybe I better stay a little calm. And everyone kind of liked that finish that I did on the other mirror. So I thought, well, you know, maybe that would be a good finish to go on here. I'm going to try to let this area dry a little bit. It just keeps. So that I can go and start. But I'll just keep painting. This is a pretty big piece. I'm going to say it's probably four to 5 feet wide. I haven't measured it yet. So, and it's heavy. So what I did here, because I've got this shelving here, what I did was I just mounted me a screw there so that I could really...
Tracy says your other mirror came out stunning.
Thank you, Tracy. But anyhow, so I'm doing the exact same finish. Of course, it's a different mirror. So it's going to look a little different simply because it's a different mirror. Actually, this one's prettier, I think. I don't know. Maybe I'll get it done and want to keep it. I don't know. Because I sold my other big gold one that I did. And I did it taupe. And it sold almost immediately. But, you know, think about your audience. You know, who's going to be looking at it. Where you're going to be advertising at. What you want to do with it. And I did want to mention, too, that, you know, in our workshops, I don't know about you guys, but most of the time I wear a hat because it keeps my hair, because I got longer hair, it keeps my hair out of my product. And then if I have to run somewhere, I can change my hat and get on something kind of glitzy and not have to worry about my hair, which I didn't worry too much about it this morning, you can tell. But we just keep working this around in all of those little nooks and crannies. And the good thing too is when you have it hanging, you can get underneath your edges and not have to keep moving. But I just put a little screw up there like I told you. You know, if there's any kind of tutorial that you guys would like to have. I know I do a lot of the image transfer things. And if you're watching this and you haven't liked our page, Ransomed Relics, please do so, because what that does is it puts, when you view things, it puts you on a bigger line, you know, on Facebook, where they're going to promote your page a little bit. So I always try to like other people's pages because it helps them. And if you haven't liked Ransomed Relics, please go there. And I know some of you have been praying for my daughter, Bethany. We thought she was going to be hospitalized on Friday. She's in kidney failure. Some of those who are new might not know that. She helps me in this business. She's the one actually who got me started because she said, Mom, you could do this and you really need to do this. And so when I get frustrated, I blame it on her. But anyway, tomorrow we will be going to Columbus, Ohio to OSU, which is where they do kidney transplants. So we sure would appreciate any prayers that you could say. This is kind of a scary time for our family. Many of you know my husband is also in kidney failure. And the reason, Bethany's 34, and the reason why she's in kidney failure was that when she was 5, she had a rare form of leukemia. And we battled that for 2.5 years. They told us she would never live. She went through 2 bone marrow transplants, 6 lung surgeries because she developed this fungus in her lung, and it was called aspergillosis. And when you live in a children's hospital for several years, you see a lot. We saw a lot. And we saw a lot of precious children and their families going through horrendous stuff.
And it's hard. It's you know, it's one thing to be in the hospital for a week or even a month or a couple months, but some of these people are in the hospital for years like we were. And in and out, up and down. One day you're told there's no hope, you know, and there's nothing they can do. And when you get to that situation in your life, you find out really honestly what's important. And I found out that what was really important in my life was, number one, my family and the Lord. And I really learned what true faith is. Faith is not the great escape that a lot of people
Tracy
want.
Tracy Hayden joined.
Hey, Tracy. She's going through a battle right now. I must be popular with Tracy's. She's going through a battle with cancer right now. And Tracy, I'm praying for you, girl. And you're going to make it. And you're going to do good. But Tracy's been in the hospital the last few times getting her treatment. And
Martha Compton says prayers.
Thank you, Martha. I appreciate it. But that's what I learned, is I learned that prayer is the thing.
Terry Muncy says, praying, dear cousin. Can't wait to see you next month.
Hey, Terry. Thanks for watching. You just see, I'm just going. Me neither. It's going to be fun. But anyhow, as Bethany struggled and we had so many things going on, what I learned through the whole thing is that God is good. And He's the one that can help you. I don't care what situation you're in. It's the Lord that gives you the strength and gives you the fortification to make it through something that hard. Because you know, when it's your baby, it's your life as a mother. And she never spent a night alone in the hospital. It was either my husband or myself or one of my sisters or one of my friends. Most of the time it was me. And, you know, I learned that faith isn't the great escape. Faith is, I love the acronym FAITH. You spell FAITH, F-A-I-T-H. And F stands for forsaking. And then A stands for all. And then I stands for I. Forsaking all, I trust Him. And when you have that armor on and you realize that there is nothing that can happen to you that God hasn't already seen, that God hasn't already realized, and you say, maybe, well, why is this happening to me? Well, the Bible says it rains on the just and the unjust. And how in the world can we witness honestly to those around us if our life is always peachy? And a lot of times we want to act like our life is all peachy, but sometimes it's not. Sometimes life is hard. And sometimes you just have to hold on to your faith and just say, Lord, You're with me regardless. And the other thing that I learned is to hold things loosely, because honestly, there's not really a lot in this life that is sure anyway. But we can be sure of our salvation. We can be sure of where we're going. Just trying to give us time to dry up there, because I know you guys don't want to go through this whole thing.
Tracy Hayden says, you're always in my heart. Love you all.
I love you too, honey. We are praying, and now that we're home, we need to get together when you get to feeling better. But anyway, just thought I'd throw that in there. Some of you might be going through a hard time. Look to the Lord. He's the one that can help you. So we're just going through here. Working that. You can already see what a difference this makes. Are you guys liking this? Hope you do. I just don't want the video to go too long. But that's got to be dry to really do our next phase. And I'm not going to do everything. Make sure when you go back through, you get your edges really well. So I think I've got this pretty good. Now, some of you might want to let it dry and do another coat, but I'll tell you the reason why I don't on these is because a lot of times I want to distress them, and I might want a little bit of that gold to go through. Now, the next thing I'm going to use, I think it might be dry enough. We'll see. Next thing I'm going to use is I used a glaze, and it's just a kind of a charcoal-y black glaze. I mix. The thing with glaze is when you start working with glaze, you have a tendency to put too much paint into it, and that makes your glaze to where you can't really move it around. And I use a water-based glaze. And I will probably put to about 3 tablespoons. I'll probably put maybe a teaspoon of paint. And I did kind of make up quite a bit. So, and the great thing that I like about glaze, now some people like to wax. I have waxed. But I found that I have more control with a glaze. And I like a glaze better. Personally myself. See, now this is a little wet, so I'm not for sure if it's going to do. It's just going to muddy up. If it's not dry, it's going to muddy up. So you know what I think I might do? I think I might just keep working the cream, and then I'll do a part two and a part three, because those go really, really quick, because I don't want to keep you guys on here. I know you've got better things to do today. So I'll come back with a part two, a real short part two, when this is all dry. It's just not dry enough. And I'll work all this in. So I'll see you guys in a little while. God bless.